Let's discuss about treating iron deficiency with intravenous iron therapy. We see iron deficiency a lot in clinical practice. We suggest oral iron supplements to start with, but for some reason they're not able to tolerate the oral iron because of the side effects, or the oral iron supplements are not effective, or they have like a malabsorption syndrome, having a small bowel problems, are not able to absorb iron. They have a continued GI bleeding, which is exceeding ability to absorb iron. They have hemodialysis patients and they have an inability to absorb iron, and there's also iron losses secondary to dialysis. And people with cancer and iron deficiency, IV iron supplements. And then if you need iron urgently so that you want to improve the blood count for, you know, they're going for a surgery or something like that, then you want to do some IV iron quickly, then we recommend IV iron therapy. Or they have like a severe anemia and they're really, really symptomatic and they really want to get the benefit of iron supplements quickly, then we sometimes do IV iron to them instead of trying oral iron supplements. Usually about a gram of iron is required in men and 600 milligrams of women to replace iron stores in the body. Some of the preparations we have include ferric gluconate complex, also called ferlicet. We do 100 to 200 milligrams at each dose. People usually require multiple doses. Iron sucrose, also called venifer. Again, we can do like 200 milligrams each dose, and multiple doses are required to get the amount of iron that a person typically needs. The other preparation is ferumoxytol or ferraheme. Typically, each dose is 5-10 milligrams. Two doses will give them 1.1 grams of iron. The other preparation is ferric carboxymaltose, also called injectifer. Each dose is 750 milligrams. Two doses make it 1.5 grams. Another preparation is ferric derisomaltose, which is monoferric. It's all one dose of 1 gram. So some of the side effects that you can experience with IV iron therapy. Typical side effects include allergic reactions. Some people can suffer a severe allergic reaction, such as anaphylactic reactions, that may end up making them go to the hospital. But that's very rare, fortunately. Otherwise, for all practical reasons, IV iron therapy is very well tolerated. So in summary, people who cannot tolerate oral iron supplements are not able to take them because of small bowel problems, or somebody who is very symptomatic will need IV iron, and most of the IV iron preparations are pretty safe. A minority can have severe side effects, but most people tolerate it very well. So anybody who has severe symptomatic iron deficiency anemia can go for IV iron therapy. Thank you for watching this.